Fala rapaziada, começando mais um vídeo aqui no canal Na Ponta da Língua. Sejam bem-vindos para mais um vídeo. No vídeo de hoje vou estar compartilhando mais uma aula que eu tive lá no Cambridge. Essa aula, assim, eu não vou dizer que ela foi boa. Essa aula, sei lá, foi um pouco diferente. A palavra certa não é boa, é legal. Foi uma aula, assim, gostosa, sabe? Sei lá, sabe? Foi uma aula com uns assuntos mais diferentes. A professora foi super gente boa, foi um amor de pessoa. Não tive dificuldade com meu inglês, questão pra entender, pra falar. Consegui me comunicar bem, com naturalidade. Eu também tava confortável, sabe? Com a mente leve, sei lá. Então foi uma aula muito gostosa de se fazer e também espero, né, que creia de se assistir. Na verdade, creio que também seja uma aula gostosa de se assistir. É, agora ficou certo. Bom, se você é novo aí, tá chegando agora e não sabe, eu tenho um e-book chamado Do Básico ao Avançado, como eu aprendi inglês em 2 anos. Esse e-book eu escrevi em comemoração aos meus 2 anos de estudo que eu tô completando agora em 2020, em dezembro de 2020. E lá eu conto um resumo de como foi todo o meu processo do básico até o avançado. Lá eu conto questão por que eu comecei a estudar inglês, como eu comecei, quem me apoiou, quem me incentivou. Mas lembrando, deixando bem claro, lá eu não ensino inglês, não vou dar dica de inglês, é apenas um resumo da minha trajetória. E se você ficou interessado em comprar, é uma ótima forma de você se inspirar. A gente sabe, né, o quão difícil é no início. Então, se você gostou, quiser usar como uma inspiração, até vou estar deixando o link para você comprar aqui na descrição. Mas fiquem tranquilos em relação ao valor, porque o valor dele é o valor mais simbólico do que qualquer outra coisa. Tá custando apenas R$10. Então dá um confere lá, check it out, o link vai estar aqui na descrição. Bom, então sem mais enrolações, vamos lá para a aula do Cambridge. Espero que vocês gostem, vocês se divirtam. No final do vídeo eu volto para falar mais com vocês. Então acompanha aí.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi, what is your name?
I'm Mateus.
Mateus. So where are you calling from today?
So, I'm sorry, what's your name?
Oh, I'm Teresa. I am Teresa.
Oh, that's nice. So, I'm calling from Brazil.
Ah, Brazil. I live in Florida. I live close to Disney World.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Oh, that's great. Is it nice there?
It's most of the year it's hot. Winter is nice. Winter is my favorite time in Florida. And in winter it rains and the weather is cool. It's a good temperature. I recommend come visit in the winter, not in the summer. Summer is so hot, you walk outside and you start sweating.
I'd like to go there, actually, because I guess maybe there are a lot of Brazilians there. Is it true?
Oh, there is. I am friends with a Brazilian family. They live 45 minutes south of me. I met them at an event, and then I met them and immediately they say, come to my son's wedding. Now come to my daughter's the christening. Oh, they invite me all the time. But now with Corona, I tell them no, because they still are partying. And I tell them, you have to be careful. You have to be careful. But they say, we have to party. Life is short. We have to party. I'm like, oh, no. You know what I'm saying? They're still partying.
Yes, yes, yes. Because in Brazil, that's not good. But nobody is caring about Corona, you know.
I am wearing my mask and I am staying away from people, and they keep asking me to come, and I tell them I am too scared. If I get Corona, that's I don't want to have that, because they are having parties with lots of people. They invite everybody.
Yes, that's a serious situation, right? Because so many people are dying, right?
Yes.
So yeah, so you have to be careful in this situation.
Yes, but if you come to Florida, it's a lot of people from Brazil. The only problem is just like people from Mexico that come here, the people from Mexico that come to Florida never learn English. And that also, yes, they never learn English. And the same thing is happening with people from Brazil, like that family I told you. They don't speak English. I speak to them in Spanish, and they understand and they try to speak to me in Spanish, but they don't know English.
I know why.
Why?
I know why. I guess, okay? Because there are a lot of Brazilians there. So yes. Many Brazilians there. So they think, oh, why am I learning English if I can't speak Portuguese there? Because there are a lot of Brazilians there. You know?
Yes, there's see, there's a lot of Brazilians and also a lot of Spanish in Florida, which is the same reason why we have Mexican people that don't know English. I am, like right now where I live, I am surrounded by Mexican people that don't know one word of English because they try to stay together. But Brazilians do that too.
Yes. That's why maybe I go to Florida is not so good for me because I'm learning English. So yes. If I go to Florida, I'm gonna run into a lot of Brazilians.
Yes.
And I'm gonna tempted to speak Portuguese, you know. And I'm learning English, so that's not good for
yes,
me.
Yes, you would be lazy. You would get lazy here with the learning English. You would get lazy. If you come to America to learn English or to work, I recommend the mid states because they don't have Spanish or people from other countries. Like, I recommend like places like Oklahoma or... you know, like the Midwest. You understand the states in between, in the middle of America.
In Nova York, is it a nice place to live?
Where? New York?
Yeah.
New York. I have been to New York 2 times. There is the city New York and there is North New York. North New York is really nice. It's more like country. But it's expensive. All of New York is very, very expensive. Like New York and California are our most expensive states.
Yes, but I'm talking about Brazilians, you know? Are there Brazilians there?
Yes, yes. Of course, there's Brazilians in New York. But they in New York, whether somebody is Spanish or Portuguese or another country, they have more pressure in New York to learn English to survive because New York is very competitive. Like only like the best people get the jobs. If you don't speak good English, if you're not the best, you won't get a job or keep a job in New York. New York is what in America we call dog eat dog state. Dog eat dog.
So New York is the city that never sleeps,
yes.
Right? So you have to be good. Good in your area, you know?
No, not just good. You have to be the best. You have to be great.
Oh, yes. I have a question
sure.
for you. It's very quickly. Can I post our conversation there? I can tell you my YouTube channel and you can search.
Oh, I'm shy. Why would you want to post?
Because my YouTube channel is about all my experience about to be learning English by myself. And I share everything about my process. And now you are in my process, you know? I can tell you right now my YouTube channel and you can search. And if you feel comfortable, you know, can I tell you?
I can look it up right now and if I feel comfortable I'll send you a message either saying yes or no. Okay, I can, because I can say on here there is a chat on Cambly, so if I feel comfortable then I
yes
will...
yes, but I'm not gonna be able to answer you later, okay, because I use 3 minutes on Cambly.
Oh.
But I'm gonna see your answer.
Oh, you can't see it if is that your YouTube that you typed?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, na ponta da língua.
Okay, let me type it real fast now. Na ponta da língua.
Yeah, It's something like at the tip of the tongue.
Oh, yes. Oh my gosh. Oh, it's just, I wish you would have told me. I would have like tried to color my hair, put the lighting, change the background, use my prettiest
That's
clothes.
no, you are pretty good, really.
Oh, you are so sweet. Okay. You can put it there. You can put it there. I am looking to in the future, be teaching on my own English as well as Spanish online. So yes, I guess you could do a little promotion for me for the future. That is where I see my life going for the future.
Oh, okay. Thanks so much, because a lot of tutors here on Cambly doesn't like that. I ask, oh, can I pause our conversation? Because I have to ask that, right?
Right.
Because that's not gonna be nice pause, and they say, no, I don't think so. I don't prefer. And oh my God, because I'm here to practice my English, But I'm also here to post the video because that's my job. And if the tutor doesn't agree, I cannot post the video, and I don't have video, I don't make money.
Oh, well, I'm glad you found a way to make money. That's good. And you're learning English. I think that's fantastic.
Yes, Cambly is a good platform to make money because Cambly is so popular on YouTube. I have videos with 100,000 of views,
Wow.
Yes, I have a playlist on my YouTube channel about Cambly, just Cambly on Cambly, and you can see the views. So Cambly is a good platform, is a good way to learn English, and that's a good way. I'm not gonna say to make money, But a good way to create videos, something like that,
Yes.
So it's almost finishing. It was a pleasure, really. So thanks so much for our class today.
You're welcome, and I'm glad I'm able to help you with your job, and maybe this will help me with a future career for me too, so we can help each other.
Yes. Yeah, so thanks so much.
You're
Bye.
welcome. Have a great day. Bye.
Have a great day.
Bye.
É isso aí, rapaziada. Esse foi o vídeo, essa foi a aula no Cambly. Que vocês acharam? Vocês concordam comigo? Foi uma aula gostosa de se assistir? Bom, se você gostou, deixa o like aqui embaixo, compartilhe com algum amigo seu, vai estar me ajudando demais. Também não esqueça de comprar o meu e-book do Básico ao Avançado, como eu aprendi inglês em 2 anos, um pequeno resumo de toda a minha trajetória. Apenas R$ 10, o link vai estar aqui na descrição. Bom, então é isso, rapaziada. Vou ficando por aqui. Muito obrigado aí pela sua visualização, o seu tempo aqui. Vejo vocês no próximo vídeo. Tamo junto e valeu!